Are you friends with a lot of fursuiters but don't know how to help them? Hi, my name is Bjorn Valentine and I hope you're having a dandy day. Today we are going to be discussing fursuit handlers and how to properly be one. For those who don't know what a fursuit handler is, they are somebody who keeps a fursuiter in check to make sure that everything is going well, smoothly, and is safe for them. Because obviously, being in that suit can hinder a lot of things. And I'm going to be going over with you right now on how to be a proper fursuit handler. I have a nice 10 easy steps for you to follow. So let's begin! Number 1. Be mentally prepared to be there for the suitor. You are there to make your fursuiter mentally and physically okay. A lot of things can happen while the person is in suit, and you just have to be there for them as a person. Always be attentive to how they are feeling at any moment of time. Number 2. Carry as much water as possible. It can be very dangerous while you're wearing a fursuit, as a lot of people know. Dehydration is a serious issue that a lot of people overlook sometimes. Please, if you think you have enough water, it probably isn't enough. Bring extra, no matter what. Especially in the fursuit head, it gets dangerously hot and can cause people to pass out. So please, carry as much water as possible for the suitor. Number 3. Be prepared to take a lot of photos for the suitor. Obviously, being known on how to use a camera is nice. Obviously, knowing how to use phone cameras for iPhone and Android is obviously really nice to know as well. You will probably have to take a lot of photos for some people because, well, suitors can't use their hands usually if they have paws. Them knee shift pose. And number 3 kind of leads into number 4. Try to get to know the suitor's proper social media channels, since some suitors, for instance, don't speak in suit. So obviously, some do have badges with that information, but if they don't, knowing their information is really nice. Or if you have a card for said handler, like if they're an artist or something like that, carry their business cards for them so you can hand them out to people to tag them in their photos and find the proper social media channels to find their suit photos or to tag them, or even find their art. There are plenty of different suitors that do not speak in suit. Even if ones can speak in suit, it might be really difficult for people to hear them, so you might as well know their social media channels just in case. Number 5. Be sure to have a fursuit brush in hand. Be ready to basically brush their fur as needed and make sure that they're comfortable with brushing them. Obviously, there are times and spaces on the person's body that are obviously sensitive, so be sure that they are comfortable with you brushing them first and be ready to brush them vigorously and often. Because obviously, if someone's coming up getting a hug or rubbing them or touching them in some certain way, you want to be able to fix said area with the brush. Number 6, always be prepared to rush somebody to the headless lounge. This kind of goes back to number 2 with carrying the water, but be sure to know how to get to the headless lounge as quickly as possible, because in case if they're feeling severely dehydrated and they need to get a breather, be sure that you know exactly the right location of where you are and how to get to the headless lounge as quickly as possible. Number 7, help guide the suitor if needed. This kind of goes with number 6, but mainly in the fact that a lot of suits have difficult vision. Some you cannot see past yourself, like they're basically like horse blinders. You can barely see in front of you. Some are even worse. Some of them, they can barely see at all. So if they do need the help, please help them as much as possible. Stairs are very dangerous for people in certain suits, so please keep that in mind. Basically be a guiding dog, so to speak. Number 8, if possible, and if you're okay with this, have snacks. Having extra snacks for them would be very delightful. Mainly because, obviously, since they're sweating and working off so many calories, and they need to rebuild up those calories, so have some form of snack for them to chew on if they need it. Because obviously, since they're doing such a workout, keeping people entertained and what they do in suit, be sure to have some form of a snack to keep them energized. Number 9. This isn't a necessity, but I threw it in there precaution-wise. Try to have some over-the-counter meds like Advil or some form of headache medication or even some form of allergy medication. Some people have severe allergies. There's a lot of people around, so you never know how people will react to each other. And number 10, just simply make sure that the fursuiter is having a good time. That is the most important thing. Because obviously, if they're not having a good time, they're not going to be able to give anybody else a good time. And that's what really matters, that the person in the suit is having a great, fantastic time at whatever event you're at. For meet, con, it doesn't matter. Make sure that your suitor is having a fantastic time. I hope everyone enjoyed all of the information I gave you all today. I hope you really liked it. I hope it was educational. And thank you guys so much for helping me reach 600 subs. It really means the world to me. Hopefully we'll reach that goal of 1,000 subs that I put myself for when I did my New Year's resolution video. I discussed that I wanted to reach 1,000 subs before the year's end. And it seems like we're slowly getting there, which is incredible. I never thought I would ever have 600 subs in the first place. So thank you very much from the bottom of my heart. I am trying my best to bring as much content as possible. And to those who come to my live streams, thank you very much. It really does mean the world to me that I get to communicate with those who watch my content. And going to the live streams is the best way for me to do that with everybody. And for those who don't know, I also have a Discord that you could totally join. If you go to one of my streams, I will probably post it in the chat and you could join through there. So you could totally join and be a part of the community that enjoys my content. And it makes it an awesome space for me to get to know you guys, because it really matters to me that I want to get to know the people who watch my content. So thank you very much. So thank you for coming. You can follow me and all the appropriate social media channels. We got Instagram and Twitter and all that good stuff. So here you go up on the screen. I want to thank you guys for coming to the video once again. I hope you guys have a dandy day, evening, and good night. See ya.